Good afternoon, everybody. You are about to watch Deeper Life Bible Church program, the Moment of Transformation. Today, by the grace of the Lord, we shall listen to our pastor, General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumuyi. You are going to be blessed. It is my wish that you call your family to come and listen to you as our pastor is blessing you with his holiness message. Be blessed.
And it shall be established unto me, and the light shall shine upon my ways. The Lord will do it in Jesus' name. We're looking at Job chapter 33. Job chapter 33, we're talking about a practical responsibility. Not just something you have in your head, theoretical responsibility, something practical. Now the Lord is saying, if you're going to experience the new blessing of this new year, the better life and the better possession and the better future, the better year of this year, is going to take this practical responsibility from you and from me and from the whole church. When I say from the whole church, that means you're not going to allow an acorn to get away with any stolen wedge of gold or Babylonish garment. You know, sometimes that's how some people disturb and how they hinder the whole church from getting everything they ought to get. We're talking about the better future and a better year and a better situation for everybody in the church. And then there's an Achan somewhere that is, you know, committing abortion over there. An Achan somewhere that is committing secret adultery and fornication with other people's wives. And then we all come to church saying, praise the Lord, there's a better year, there's a better future, and that Achan will then hinder the blessings of God upon the rest of the people. And if you know such an Achan and you're keeping him or keeping her, keeping quiet, then you're the one that is hindering the better future that we're talking about. But when the cleansing hand of the Lord and the purging hand of the Lord reaches everybody and reaches all our hearts, and we're saying, praise the Lord, there's cleansing here. Praise the Lord, there's the grace of God here. Praise the Lord, there's righteousness here. I believe that the better future we're talking about will be for the whole church, for you, for me, and for every one of us in Jesus' name. We're looking at Job chapter 33, and I'm reading from verse 23. Job chapter 33, verse 23. If there be a messenger with him, an interpreter, one among a thousand, to show unto man his uprightness, then he is gracious unto him, and saith, deliver him from going down to the pit. I have found a ransom. His flesh shall be fresher than a child's, and he shall return to the days of his youth. He shall pray unto God, and he will be favorable unto him, and he shall see his face with joy, for he will rain down to man his righteousness. He looketh upon men, and if any say, I have sinned and perverted that which was right, and it profiteth me not, then he will deliver his soul from going into the pit, and his life shall see the light. You see a responsibility there. It's telling us what we need to do, how we need to cleanse our lives, and how we need to live right, so that as we're living right according to his word, according to the provision that he has made, then he says that all the goodness of the Lord will be upon us, and that goodness will be upon your life in Jesus' name. We're looking at Job chapter 36. Job chapter 36, I read from verse 9. Job chapter 36, verse 9. Then he showeth them their work and their transgressions that they have exceeded. He openeth also their ear to discipline, and commandeth that they return from iniquity. You see that responsibility there? You see what challenges is giving us, and you see what calling is giving every one of us, that we return from iniquity. And then he says, if they obey and serve him, we're going to obey. Yeah. I said we're going to obey. You know, when the Lord brings his word to us, whether it's coming out inside the scripture, or coming out from the summary or question and answer, or it's coming out from, you know, the message and the preaching, or coming out from the Monday Bible study, and it says, this is the way, walk ye therein. And we say, yes, Lord, we thank you, Lord. You have revealed your mind. That's exactly what we're going to do. And as we do that, in obedience to the Lord, it says the blessings will be upon our lives. Look at that verse now. If they obey, in verse 11, and serve him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasures. That's what the Lord is going to do. Blessings are coming upon us and blessings descending upon our lives. Even this year, this better future is starting already. I said it's starting already. And you are going to partake us of that in Jesus' name. And yet the Lord is saying, for the better future to really take root and to be prevalent in our lives, that we need this practical responsibility for that better future. Isaiah chapter 1. I'm reading there from verse 16. Isaiah chapter 1. We're looking at verse 16. Wash you, make you clean, put away the evil of your doings from before mine eyes. Cease to do evil. You know, there are some people that live as if they are atheists. Atheists are the people that they don't believe there is God. And there are some people that they come to church, they read the Bible, and they say there's a new year, and then they act as if God is not in their house. As if God will not see what they do behind the closed doors. As if God will not understand. God will not see what they do in the secret. Those are atheists. Even though they come to church, they don't believe that God sees everything that is done under the sun and behind every closed door. That's why the Lord is saying, I see you. I know what you are doing. You may hide it from man. You cannot hide it from God. That's why it says, cease to do evil. And it says, wash you, make you clean, and put away the evil of your being from before mine eyes. Learn to do well, in verse 17. And then it says, seek judgment and relieve the oppressed. Judge the fatherless and plead for the widow. And then after you've done that, come now and let us reason together, says the Lord. Then it says, though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow, and though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. Then it says this wonderful verse of scripture, which shows us that once you fulfill your responsibility, then the revelation of that prophetic future, better future, will come upon your life, and it's coming. I said it's coming. It will come in Jesus' name. Here is the condition. If ye be willing and obedient, ye shall eat the good of the land. If ye be willing and obedient, ye shall eat the good of the land. I will eat the good of the land. You will eat the good of the land. And this church, we're going to eat and partake of the goodness of this land in Jesus' name. Isaiah chapter 55. Isaiah chapter 55. We're looking at this. We're looking at the responsibility he has given us and the things we ought to do so that the blessings of the Lord will be upon our lives. And this year, definitely, as we just go through this, in obedience to the word of God, not taking anything away, not adding anything, and we just say, the Lord has said it, and because the Lord has said it, we're going to do exactly what the Lord has said. Because it's of purer eyes than to behold iniquity. He will never excuse iniquity or sin or immorality in any way. And because of that, we're following through and following with him. And the Lord is going to bless our lives. Isaiah chapter 55, I'm reading from verse 6. It says, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he's near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the righteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. It said, here is our responsibility. It says, let the wicked forsake his way. You know, the wicked people, they have all their ways. A thief has his own way of stealing. A robber has his way of robbing. A drunkard has his way of drinking. A smoker has his way of smoking. And, you know, all these prostitutes, they have their way of prostitution. And he says, whatever way it is, different from one sinner to the other, let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man is thought, and let him return, come back, and seek the Lord. And then as you plead the mercy of God, and for the forgiveness of God, and the love of God, and the grace of God, then he says he will abundantly pardon. Then he says, in verse 8, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. For as the rain cometh down, and the snow from heaven, and returneth not hither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it to bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower, and bread to the eater. It says, so shall my word be. So shall my word be. The word of promise, and the word of prosperity, and the word of healing, and the word of deliverance, and the word of blessing. He says, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the things whereto I sent it. And then he says, for ye shall go out with joy. This today, you are going out with joy. From this service, you are going out with joy. The joy of answered prayer. The joy of salvation. The joy of deliverance. And the joy of the peace of God in your heart. And the joy of fulfillment. The fulfillment of the promises of God. That God said so, and God has done it. I feel it in my soul. I see it in my body. I sense it in my spirit. The joy that God has answered our prayer. Ye shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace. For the mountains and the hills shall break forth before you into singing, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Instead of thorns, they shall come up the fir tree, and instead of briar shall come up the myrtle tree, and it shall be to the Lord for a name, for an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. What a great thing the Lord is going to do. But you see, all those great things, they are inch on the very fact that God wants us to fulfill our own responsibility. And as we do that, he says, the blessings will flow and overflow in our lives, in your life, in your family, and in the church as a whole, in Jesus' name. We're looking at Isaiah chapter 58. Isaiah chapter 58. I'm showing you something in the word of God, that there's a cause and effect. There's something that happens when you do your part. There's something that happens when man fulfills his responsibility, that God then brings the revelation and the fulfillment of all his promises upon us. And I believe that that is what you are in for this year, because this year is a year of breakthrough. It's a year of supernatural blessing. It's a year of better things happening unto us. And it is hinged and focused on the very fact that he wants us to fulfill this responsibility. And after that, great things, mighty things happening upon us in our lives, in Jesus' name. Isaiah chapter 58, and I'm reading there from verse 8. Look at this. It says, then shall thy light break forth as the morning, and thy health shall spring forth speedily, and thy righteousness shall go before thee, and the glory of the Lord shall be thy reward. Then shalt thou call, and the Lord shall answer. Thou shalt cry, and he shall say, here I am, if thou take away. You see that? There's something to take away. It says, this will happen, good thing will happen, better things will happen, provision of the Lord, prosperity of the Lord, and the peace of God, and the joy of the Lord. And then it says, if thou take away from the midst of thee the yoke, and the putting forth of the finger, and the speaking of vanity, and if thou draw out thy soul to the hungry, and satisfy the afflicted soul. And then it says, then shall thy light rise in obscurity, and thy darkness shall be as the noonday. Then the Lord shall guide thee continually, and satisfy thy soul in drought, and make fat thy bones, and thou shalt be like a watered garden, and like a spring of water whose waters fail not. And they that be of thee shall build the old ways places. You know, all this is telling us, fulfill your responsibility, and then I'm going to do these wonderful things unto you. And then he tells us over there, he says, thou shalt raise up the foundations of many generations, and thou shalt be called the repairer of the breach, and the restorer of paths to dwell in. That's the blessings of the Lord. Those are the blessings of the Lord, and the blessings will be upon us in Jesus' name. Jeremiah chapter 6. Jeremiah chapter 6. We're looking at verse 16. Jeremiah 6, verse 16. Thus says the Lord, This is the word of God, not the word of man. If we are going to have the revelation of the better future, and it's going to be fulfilled in our lives, it says, this is what the Lord is saying. It says, thus says the Lord. In verse 16, stand ye in the ways, and see, and ask for the old paths. Where is the good way? And walk therein, and ye shall find rest for your souls. It says, if we're going to have it, this is how to have it, that better future. It says, we're going to find the old way, that is the way of the Lord and the way of the scripture, the highway of holiness, and we'll walk therein, and then we'll find rest and restoration and revelation of the better future in every one of our lives. I pray it will happen to every one of us in Jesus' name. I come to point number three now, is the progressive realization of a better future. Progressive. That is, you start now, and then you move on, and then you move on, and then you move on until that better future comes. And it is coming upon us in Jesus' name. I want you to see something here. If this better future is going to come, and if this better thing the Lord has promised, if it's going to come, here is what the Lord is saying is going to happen. Let's look at this in Isaiah chapter 52. Isaiah chapter 52. I'm reading to you here from verse 1. Isaiah chapter 52, verse 1. Awake. Awake, put on thy strength, O Zion, put on thy beautiful garments, O Jerusalem. And then it says, the holy city, for henceforth there shall no more come into thee the uncircumcised and the unclean. It's telling us the better future, if that better future is going to come. It says, awake, it says, arise. Something new is happening. A better future is starting for you. A better year, a new year is coming for you. And it says, arise and do it. Arise and fulfill the responsibility. And then it says, great things, and mighty things are going to happen. Then it says, listen to this. It says, henceforth. It says, from this very moment, from this January, from this beginning of the year, the unclean and the circumcised will no more come into you. And then in verse 2, shake thyself from the doors, and arise and sit down, O Jerusalem, and loose thyself from the bands of thy neck, O captive daughter of Zion. What a wonderful thing. The Lord is telling us that, you know, as you do the will of God and say, here am I, Lord, I'm going to be who you want me to be this year. I'm shaking myself out of the dust, out of the dirt, out of the defilement, out of that immorality, all those things that happened last year, they were covered up. There's cleansing this year. There's righteousness this year. There is a kind of life that is straightforward this year. A life that's above all the defilement, and then you live a life above reproach this year. And it says, it is when you come with that conviction before the Lord, it says, I'm going to so much bless you. I'm going to so much get you over to the better future and the better life. And I'm praying it will happen in Jesus' name. But I want to remind you, you shake yourself from the dust. Shake yourself from the dirt. Shake yourself from the defilement. And shake yourself from every hidden sin. As you do that, you are going to discover that God is a faithful God. Be responsible and do your part. And then the goodness of the Lord will come upon you. Look at verse 7. Verse 7, how beautiful. Upon the mountains, at the feet of him that bringeth good tidings. And then he said, that publisheth peace, and that bringeth good tidings of good, and publishes salvation, and says unto Zion, thy God reigneth. That brings us back to what the Lord, I'm emphasizing for us. That's the evangelism. Getting to the people, how beautiful are the feet of them that publish the good.